come.
It's prophecy.
And he says, he shall establish it with judgment from henceforth and forever. David's government didn't last forever. The zeal of Adonai of hosts will perform this. That's what it says. That's what it says. So now, when we look at the Torah, it's speaking of HaMashiach, Yahusha, in this manner. Read Bereshit 49 and 10. Watch this. You got to know how. Well, it's beautiful how the scriptures line up. Man.
Can I ask?
The book of Bereshit. Some of y'all might call it Genesis, chapter 49, verse 10. The scepter shall not depart from Judah, nor a lawgiver from between his feet, until Shiloh come, and until unto him shall the gathering of his people be, of the people be, Selakim.
Okay, JD, you could ask your question, but what is Shiloh?
Shiloh is from Shalom, which is peace. I totally understand the concept of the Messiah, but I'm not seeing the connection between Yahushua and Messiah. I'm not, no offense in this situation, just in where we're talking about right there with the way the scripture is written. It I don't know the connection between Yahushua or Elijah or et cetera, or the future or Rav Soloveitchik or the Bavitcher Rebbe. I mean, you know, whoever believes the Messiah is what they believe is. But I don't see that connection with Yahushua there yet.
Okay.
You know,
we're not done yet, JD.
No, I know. I want to go to the Levites. I'm trying to figure out the Levite situation, because if Yahushua is from David or from Judah.
No, he's not a Levitical priest.
So how do you get into the Holy of Holies?
He's not from the Levitical priesthood.
But how do you get inside the Holy of Holies?
Because the Levitical priesthood was taken away from them.
Oh. Well, that was the time of the Second Temple. Yeah.
And that's why all royalty came from the tribe of Judah.
Let's go to Deuteronomy 18 and 15.
Come. Book of Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 15. Yahuwah, thy supreme Elohim, will raise up unto thee a prophet from the midst of thee, of thy brethren, like unto me. Unto him ye shall hearken.
Unto who? Like unto who? Like unto who?
Like unto me.
Who's talking here? Moshe is talking. So now the question becomes, JD, which one of the ways HaMashiach was like Moses?
He was a shepherd. Like Moses? He's supposed to be a shepherd, right?
No. Okay. One of the ways that he was parallel to Moses. When Moses was born, all of the children's 2 years and younger, a death decree went out to murder all the children's 2 years and under to prevent a savior from saving Israel. This was repeated with Yahusha. Same thing was repeated.
The male children, right?
All males 2 years and under. Deuteronomy 18, verse 19.
Con, the book of Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy chapter 18, verse 19. And it shall come to pass that whosoever will not hearken unto my words, which he shall speak in my name, I will require it of them.
Who are they talking about here, JD? Who is that?
Mashiach.
The father said that. Who said that? The father said that. Let's get 2 Samuel 7 and 12.
Come on, the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 7, verse 12. And when thy days be fulfilled.
Who is he talking to? Who is he talking to right? Hold on. Who's he talking to right here, JD? He's talking to David. What's this? Read.
Come on, the book of 2 Samuel, chapter 7, verse 12. And when thy days be fulfilled, and thou shalt sleep with thy fathers, I will set up thy seed after thee, which shall proceed out of thy bowels, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. I will be his father, and he shall be my son. If he commit iniquity,
stop. I gotta make sure JD get this understanding. JD, this can't be talking about Solomon. Solomon was never referred to as Bar or the son of Yahuwah. But HaMashiach was. It says, I will be his father and he shall be my son. If he commit iniquity, I would chastise them with the rod of men and with stripes of the children of men. This prophecy came to read it earlier tonight when the Roman with the leather strips with lead in them. This prophecy has been fulfilled right here. Read that again, man, so he could get the understanding.
Come. 2 Samuel chapter 7, verse 12. And when thy days be fulfilled, and thou shalt sleep with thy fathers.
When David shall sleep in the earth, God.
I will set up thy seed after thee, which shall proceed out of thy bowels, and I will
establish. He came out of the seed line of David. God.
Come. He shall build an house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever.
Okay, stop. That word right there does it. Forever. The throne. See, some people say, oh, this is talking about David's son, Solomon. No, it's not. No, it's not. A new Jerusalem is going to come down from the sky. That's what the prophecy says. And Solomon's kingdom didn't last forever. It was under Solomon that the kingdom was divided because he sinned. So that's when the kingdom divided into two different kingdoms. The southern kingdom took on the name Yahusha, and their headquarters was in Jerusalem. And the northern kingdom retained the name Israel, and their headquarters was in Samaria.
Yeah, there's an old city.
So it couldn't have been talking about Solomon. Who is this talking about? A Messiah.
The Messiah.
A Messiah.
I totally agree.
It says this kingdom will last forever. Go ahead.
Verse 14, I will be his father and he shall be my son.
I will be his father and he shall be my son. Boy, that thing's heavy right there, JD.
I'm with you.
God.
If he commit iniquity, I will chasten him with the rod of men and with the stripes.
Now, stop. Does anyone remember where I had you guys read that earlier? When they was beating HaMashiach? When he went?
In the Romans.
Into the court? And they stripped him down? And Pilate had him beat? Man, you guys got to pay attention to this stuff, man. I may not be always around to teach it.
So far.
I want to read you guys when you have a chance. I'd like to read something to you. I don't want to interrupt.
Go ahead, JD.
So in the Torah, Yahusha's name is taboo, right? Because of many reasons, what they say is because he was sharing certain information that and certain stuff that was not supposed to be shared. I don't know. I wasn't there, right? But when you reference Mashiach, it says in Melachim or angels, right? It's Melachim. It says HaMelech HaMashiach, in the future, the king, the Messianic king, It says Atid La'amod will arise and renew. Midchazer Melachot from the Davidic dynasty. And it says Melachot David Lishana, and it's restoring to his initial sovereignty. It says and it says he will build a temple and gather the dispersed of Israel. And it says v'chozrin kol mishpatim bayumav kishehu mikodem. And it says, and then in his days, the observant of all the statutes, the laws, will return to the previous state. Mm-hmm. And it goes on and says mikruvim mikorbanot ve'osim shmitin u'yovelot kechol mitzvatan hamru b'torah. It says, and then we offer sacrifices and observe the sabbatical and the jubilee years according to all the particulars as it's described by the Torah. It says, anyone who does not believe in him, whenever he doesn't believe in him, or somebody doesn't even wait for him or denies his coming. It says, "Lo b'shar navim bilvad hu kofer." It says, denies not only the statements of the other prophets, but those of the Torah and Moshe, our teacher. And Moshe Rabbeinu, Sharei b'Torah etid alav. And it says, the Torah testified it is coming, as it says in Devarim or Deuteronomy 35. It says like this: "V'shev Hashem Elohecha et shivutecha ve." It says, and God will bring back your captivity and have mercy upon you. He will again gather you from amongst the nations, even if your diaspora is at the ends of the heavens. God will gather you up from there and bring you to the land. So this is almost like there is a Messiah. The Messiah is coming. It's going to, of course, as we know, it's going to redeem everybody, right? And these explicit words of the Torah include all the statements made by all the prophets. And the reference to Mashiach is made in a portion with Bilam, and we know about Bilam, who prophesied the prophecies about two anointed kings. The first anointed king was David, who saved Israel from her oppressors, and the final anointed king was going to come, to who will arise from the descendants and save Israel in the end of days. And that's from Mabidbar, or Numbers 24:17. It says like this. Kehov mi Yaakov ze David, and I see now it refers to David. The Kam Shevat Misrael, and it comes from the tribe of Israel. It says, I perceive, but not in the near future. It says b'machetz b'tei Moav ze David. He says, and this is referring to David. He says, it refers to the Messianic King. A star shall go, and now it goes, I guess it goes Mishmuel in the Shmuel book in the book of Samuel. It says, a star shall go forth from Jacob. This refers to David. And a staff shall arise in Israel. This refers to the Messianic King. Then it says, crushing all of Moab's princes. This refers to David, as it says in Samuel number 2. He says, he smote Moab and measured them with a line. Decimating all of Seth's descendants. This refers to the Messianic King about whom Zechariah prophesies will rule from sea to sea. And he says, Edom will be demolished. This refers to David as in Samuel, and it states Edom became the servants of David. So we know where it's coming. We know where the king is coming from. The Mashiach is coming from David.
Yes.
But where I'm trying to figure out is where we get Yahusha. And I know the references are there. I know the references are there. But the one biggest reference that I'm having a disconnect is. We're still living. We're still here. We're not saved yet. I mean, like, what are we? Why are we still here then? You know, like, I thought it was
because there's a second coming. See, you're thinking just like Barabbas was thinking back there.
Mm-hmm.
When HaMashiach came, Barabbas wanted him to join on to the Zealots and go to war against the Romans, but that's not why he came the first time. He came. Let me ask you this, JD. In the law, right? In the Torah, when one would actually commit a sin, what did you do for remission of sins? What must they do if they committed a sin? How was they forgiven?
Teshuva, you have to do repentance. There's certain ways you have to do, but repentance, you have to repent.
Yeah, but how did they do it?
Well, it depends. They take sacrifices for one. They do.
Oh, no. Okay. Say that again. They did what?
There's a few different ways that they make teshuva, which is repentance, and there's certain ways to repent.
I'm talking about according to the Torah.
The Torah. You bring sacrifice. It depends on what you've done. You either get punished, right? Then you bring sacrifices.
For forgiveness, what did they do?
You have to ask for.
You sacrifice an animal.
Yeah, you give you sacrifices. Yeah.
Yeah.
Teshuva. So,
okay, I'm saying that right because. Mm-hmm. That was a way of asking for forgiveness of a sin, right? So, but the Israelites became so accustomed to sinning that they would commit a sin and then go and offer a sacrifice and ask for forgiveness. And so this is why when Saul went against the words of the Most High, when he went to war against the Philistines and he didn't kill the king and he took the livestock and he didn't do what he was ordered to do, Samuel told him, because you've disobeyed Yahuwah Elohim, the kingdom will be taken away from you and given to someone else. Obedience is better than sacrifice. So the animal of sacrifice was done away with when HaMashiach came, because he came and he gave his blood and he died on the crux for forgiveness of sins of the whole nation of Israel. And the people didn't accept it at the time. And so because they didn't, just like kind of what you're doing, the Sanhedrin wanted him dead. When he said that, hey, I'm the Savior, I'm the Messiah, they charged him with blasphemy. They charged him with the Roman crime of sedition. They charged him with the Roman crime of, what's the other thing I said they charged him with earlier? Sedition, treason, They charged him about six times, man.
Did they have to charge him? Did they have to charge him? They were crucifying people left and right over there. Crucifying.
No, I'm not talking about the Romans. Because this would have never happened. Who was responsible for this under Annas and Caiaphas?
Salaki, you cut off.
The two high priests. What?
You cut off. You said this would have never happened, and then.
Yeah, I don't know when I cut. I don't know when I cut out. It was the two high priests that was responsible for it. Let's get some more precepts, man. Because I need to put this out there, man. Let's get some more precept. Let's go to Telaim 2:7. Psalms 2:7. Someone want to grab that? Or you guys went to sleep? It is at the 12, man. How long have I been on here?
You've been all day, man. You've been doing this all day. You're a machine.
You're a machine. Come on. The book of Psalms, Telahim.
3 hours and 30 minutes.
Chapter 2, verse 7. I will declare the decree. It's
12 o'clock today, man.
You're a machine, man. You're a machine. It's unbelievable. Unbelievable.
I will declare the decree. Yahuwah hath said unto me, thou art my son. This day have I begotten thee.
You hear that, JD? Who's he talking about?
The Messiah.
Okay.
Thou art
good.
My son. Come.
I'm with you. I'm with you.
Good. Let's go to Psalms 22:16.
Yep, that's the one.
This Come. Prophecy was fulfilled.
Come. The book of Psalms, Telahim, chapter 22, verse 16, reads, for dogs have compassed me, the assembly of the wicked have enclosed me, they pierce my hands and my feet.
Mm-hmm. Who's that talking about, JD? That's prophecy of what was going to happen to a HaMashiach.
Oh.
And he got pierced on the cross.
Like I said, many, I'm not saying that he didn't mean it, but many of them were.
Who is it talking about then, JD?
Messiah.
Tell me that I should know. But HaMashiach, this, he fulfilled this prophecy.
Come on.
Did Matthew. He not?
The second coming, the second coming, you're saying, right?
No. This was already fulfilled by him.
Okay.